Welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's class, in this amazing video, we are going to be looking at what we call undefined fraction. Okay, class? Now, what is an undefined fraction? A fraction is undefined, or we can use the word not defined, if the denominator equals zero. Okay? So, another question that will now arise is this. What is now a fraction? Okay, a fraction is any expression of the form something all over something. Okay, so if I have something like this, this all over this, we call this expression a fraction, meaning the one on top is what we call the what now? Numerator. Okay, we call the one on top numerator, and we call the one below denominator. Okay, class. We call it what now? Denominator. So which implies a fraction must have two parts. The one on top that we call numerator, and the one below that we call denominator. So under undefined fraction, our case and our analysis will be just on the denominator. We don't have anything to do, class, with the numerator. Okay? Because from the definition we said a fraction is undefined if the denominator is equal to what now? Zero. So which implies, if you want to solve any question under undefined fraction, we just take the denominator only, the one below, and we equate it to what now? Zero, okay? So we have some questions here to be solved, okay? Question says, we should find the value or values of x for which the fractions are undefined, okay? So we have the first one here, we have the second one here, we have the third one here. Class. What is an undefined fraction? It is when the what now? Denominator is equal to what now? Zero. So I'll just take this, I'll equate it to zero. I'll take this, I'll equate it to zero. I'll take this, I'll equate it to what now? To zero. And I'll get my what now? My result. Okay? Is it clear, class? So let's solve the first one. Let's solve the first one. So this fraction here will be undefined when what now? When what? When x minus 2 equals to what now? Zero. Okay, so we are looking for what now? For x, the value of x that will make this thing undefined. Okay, so which implies this one will go to this side. We have our x to be equal to what now? 2. So that's the solution to question number what? Question number one. Do you see how simple the thing is? What undefined fraction is telling us is this, meaning we must have a zero here, everything must be equal to zero. And when I put what now? When we put 2 here, what is 2 minus 2? 2 minus 2 gives us what now? Zero. So anything all over zero will make that thing undefined. Do we understand? So the concept is everything here must go to what now? That is the what? The denominator must go to what now? Zero. Okay? So let's take question number two. Number two says 3x cubed minus 4x squared plus 9 all over x squared minus what now? Minus 4. When will this thing be what now? Undefined. We don't have any business to do with the what now? Numerator. Our business is on the what now? Denominator, okay? So b, so this expression will be what now? Undefined. When what class? When x squared minus 4 equals what now? Zero, okay? I can break this one down to what now? 2 raised to the power of what? Of 2, okay? So here we have what now? X squared minus 2 raised to the power of 2 equals what now? Zero class. What is the meaning of 2 raised to the power of 2? That's what now? 2 times 2, and that becomes what now? 4. Now class, what we have here, are you with me? Now leads to what we call another concept in mathematics that we call what now? Difference of two squared. Meaning, anytime I have x squared minus y squared, our result must be equal to x minus y in one bracket, then x plus y in the what now? Other bracket. Do we understand this? Meaning, this is the result. Anytime I have something like this in mathematics, I have one square here, I want another square here. What is between them is what now? It's minus. My result must go what now? X minus 2 in one bracket, then x plus 2 in the other what now? Bracket. And everything goes to what now? Zero. Do we understand that now? So that is the major what now? That is the major rule. Meaning whenever I have difference of 2 squared, okay, I will have x minus 1 in one bracket, then x plus what? Y in the other what now? Bracket. And that is what I have used here. So x minus 2 in this bracket, then x plus 2 in the other bracket, okay, equals to what now? Is 0. So this thing means what? Either what? X minus 2 equals to what? 0. Or x plus 2 equals to what now? 0.
So what's the value of x here? X is equal to what now? 2. Or x equals what now? Minus 2. So which implies our answer to this means x equals what? Minus 2 or what? Or 2. So when I put minus 2 here, everything here will give us what now? Is 0. When I put plus 2 here, everything will give us what now? Do you understand what I'm saying? Because if I put what plus 2, that would be what now? 2 squared, which is 4. Common as 4 is what now? Is 0, okay? If I put minus 2 here, I want minus 2 also will give us what now? 4. What is 4 minus 4? Is 0. The major concept, I repeat, the major concept under what now? Undefined fraction is just to make sure that the denominator is equal to what now? Is 0. And we'll get our what? Our result, okay? So let's take the third one. Class, let's take the third one. Third one says, x squared minus 49 all over x squared minus 9x plus 20. Okay, so our target here is what to what now? We have things to do with what now? With this what? Denominator only. Okay? So here we'll now be having what now? When what, class? When x squared minus 9 what? 9x plus 20 equals to what now? 0. This is where this thing wrote now. Undefined. Okay? So this thing forms what we call a quadratic what? Equation. Okay, so here we'll find two factors of what of this 20 that when we add we'll have minus 9 and when we multiply we'll have what now 20. I repeat, we'll find two factors of this what now this 20 that when we add the two factors together we have what now minus 9 and when we multiply the two factors we have what plus 20. Okay, I think that will be what now minus 4 and minus 5. So here we'll have that being x squared minus 4x minus 5x plus what now? 20 equals to what now? 0. You get the concept that meaning minus 5 minus 4, that would be what now? Minus 9. Minus 4 times minus 5, that would be what now? Plus 20. So we now group. We group. What's common between this one and this one? X is common. We left it what here? X. Okay? So here we left it what now? 4. Do you understand what I'm trying to do here? So once I have this concept here, immediately I'll open another bracket. That is just a shortcut under what now? Under operation here. Immediately I will open another bracket and I'll put what I have here in the bracket too, okay? So we have what now? X minus what now? 4 equals to what now? 0. So this is the second what now? Second group, okay? So I've brought X out. Are you with me? What is left here is what now? Minus what? Minus 5. So minus 5 times X give us what? Minus 5X. Minus 5 times minus 4 give us what now? Plus 20. Okay, class, do you understand this? Now, can I continue? All right. So here we now have what now? I'll bring one of these out. We have what? X minus 4. Then I'll take the next one. X minus 5. That's the remainder. X minus what now? 5 equals to what now? 0. What is this thing telling us? It means either what? X minus 4 equals to 0 or X minus 5 equals to what now? 0. Just similar to what we've done here. Okay? So here we now have been X minus 4 equals to what? 0. Or X minus 5 equals to what now? 0. So our X will be equals to what now? 4. Or x equals to what now? 5. Okay, so the answer to this question is what now? 4 or 5. Meaning, if I put 4 here, everything will give us what now? 0. Likewise, if I put 5 here, everything will give us what now? 0. Are you with me, class? So, this is all the things that we need to what now? These are all the things that we need to learn under what now? Undefined fraction. We just take the what now? Denominator only. We don't have any what now? Any business to do with the what? Numerator. Just take the numerator and we place it to what now? To 0. And we'll solve the way I've solved everything here. Okay? So please clap. If you've enjoyed this what now, this lecture, and you want me to produce more amazing lectures like this, I want you to please kindly subscribe to my YouTube channel by clicking the red subscribe button below this video. Okay? And you turn on what now? The bell icon beside that what? That subscribe button, okay? And please, share these videos, all right? Share these videos with your friends, your loved ones, and share with everybody. Please, I want this video to go viral. Most especially to students writing what now? Writing why? Share this video with all of them. Thank you very much for watching. And again, don't forget, you can watch any of my videos on what now? On the screen right now. You can watch any of my videos on the screen, showing on the screen right now. Thank you very much for watching. I will see you in the next class.